You know what I like? Fun things. This is Orcs, and it is a fun thing. And part of the reason it's a fun thing is because it took three amazingly fun things and took the best bits of all of them and combined them into one. Say you take the award-winning tabletop game Carcassonne, and then the immensely fun zombie survival game They Are Billions, and you mixed it with a little bit of Slay the Spire's deck-building roguelike mechanics. Well, you put all that in a cauldron, and you get Orcs. This game is incredible. I'm loving it. I played it one time already. But essentially, for those of you who've played Carcassonne already, you're like, wait a minute, that looks a little bit familiar. That castle's all funny curvy walls, and I see these little tiles with some road sections on it. Well, Carcassonne plays in a way that you're trying to build out a map and complete certain features. You get money for completing it. Like, if you complete a rogue section, you get money. If you complete a castle, you get money. And the way Orcs plays is you're trying to do that while you're gonna be attacked by endless hordes of zombies. Well, not zombies. But I do love being attacked by zombies. They're Orcs, thus the name of the game. There's a few interesting new mechanics, like as we build out, and I'll show you that in a moment, we're gonna be building roads out. If we complete a structure next to these vaults, we're going to get an amazing new power. So we're gonna have to find the first one, or the closest one to us, and try to build out towards us. Now we need to build a building next to it, from my understanding. So I think that could be a castle, a mine, or a farmland. And yes, they do call them mines in this game.
A mine!
So one of the things that we could do is farmland, plus 2 delayed gold, and it dead ends a road, so it would complete a road section. So if I wanted to put one right here, boom! I completed the road, so I got 2 gold there, and then I also got 2 gold for the farm. Now, the longer the roads, I believe the more gold you can get, and we're gonna want more gold because we're gonna want to build castles. Because unlike Carcassonne, where you're building castles for gold, you're building castles in Orcs to defend against the waves of Orcs. So right here on the left-hand side of the screen, in 37 seconds is when we're gonna get first attacked. So I think I might also get money for villages. There's certain things that I gotta figure out, like, will that add to my populace? And then I can redraw and get some new cards here. So we're gonna hit play and let this start playing out. And you can tell the speed of the game by how fast the flags are moving. Ooh, we got a nice wall section here. I really wanna start building up to this vault up here. So this would probably be the fastest way to get there. And let's see, I've got 4 gold, so I could start building a castle if I wanted. It'd be a little bit tricky, but I'm thinking if we put this section here. Now, that's a wall, and guys could fire arrows from it, but for the purposes of this game, they're not gonna fire until the castle is completed. So there's nobody there. The only protection I have is from the heart of my castle. Although I could produce militia. Ooh, here's a mine. So exhausting after 1 usage, it increases 30% health and it acts as a road. Interesting. I thought it would produce money because we want some money. All right, here we go. This is good. I could complete this little castle here and voila, once it's completed, and it looks kind of funny, and that's just the way Carcassonne castles are. I remember looking at the pieces the first time I played, I'm like, that is a strange looking castle. So what we can do is we can build a straight road here, and then I can curve this road back, and if I just want to rotate it, I've got this little rotate piece, and voila. So the first waves are attacking, and the objectives here are to open the 3 vaults, and here's one of them, a common vault. This one is a legendary vault, and this one is also a common vault. So in hindsight, I probably should have gone for the legendary one, because legendary just sounds better than common, doesn't it? But yeah, so essentially what happens now is completed castles and like bands of militia, those are the things that I've been exposed to in the game so far, they can go out and fight. And well, they don't go out. They fire arrows and they defeat the guys that are attacking you. So here's the Orcs. So this is kind of where it gives you that They Are Billions type of feel. And I'm gonna wanna try to build castles on all sides. They'll get close to the castle and they will attempt to destroy it. So a blacksmith, exhausting after 1 usage, aura increases. So if I put this here, then I should unlock that vault. Let's see. Aha, so I unlock the vault and it gives me cards. Okay. So I can choose one of these, right? And this actually kind of reminds me, the card building mechanics, a little bit of Retropolis, which is a game I rather much enjoyed. I think I like the castle with the crossroads, honestly. So I'm gonna do that, we unlock that. Now we should make our way to this other legendary vault. So let's go ahead and start. I wanna complete this road section just to get some gold. So voila, 12 passive gold, beautiful. So I'm gonna start this one here. That's going to be tricky. I'll do it this way. So I can build a castle out like this. See? Now all I need is an end piece right there. We need a little bit of redraw so I can build some more roads and try to build over to this legendary one. Aha, see, look. Castle's completed. It's minus 2 gold, but it's added defense. Now here's another farm piece, and I could put this guy right... Let's put it right here. It'll be in the protection of that castle. I'll get a little bit more gold. And they call it a mine. A mine! Anytime there's a mine in a game, I have to say it. Gimli made me do it. So let's build a little bit. That's a village next to this castle. Look at that. And you can see where the population centers are, i.e. where the orcs are going to attack, because they glow up at night. Now, I could try to build a wall section this way, I think. And, ooh, I can build some militia. So they're attacking from what side? Let's try to zoom out. Okay, here they are. So let's just go ahead and put some militia right here. And I think they should go out and fight. And if I do this, after 3 uses, rune +4 attack to the castles or warriors. So we're going to stack this castle and make it a little stronger because it is the tip of the spear at the moment. The militia are also going out. I could make a nice and quick little castle. Yes, look, we got 2 little castles on this point here to fire arrows at the I keep saying zombies, I know. They're orcs. The game is literally called orcs. And I'm like... Hey, man, there's zombies out there. Okay, so I think what we'll do is we'll put a castle right here. If I complete a castle, I should open that legendary card. Now, I believe I can repair these castles if they do get damaged over the nighttime. Okay, this will just be a very strong castle way out here. Whoa! After exhausting, castle increases gold cap by 2. So this is truly legendary. Now, how much gold do I have? I could try to save up for this. Exhaust is after 1 usage. I think it upgrades my main castle. I've actually never unlocked a legendary vault before. So I didn't complete anything, but I did build a building right next to it. Okay, so I want to use that. I'm going to have to save up for that, I believe. We're going to need to complete some road sections. Completed farms are good monies. This is a nice little protected area with all these castles. Okay. So we've unlocked 2 vaults, and that is our secondary objective, and we've survived 2 waves. So, I mean, honestly, I feel like we're doing pretty good already. We can wait on this castle heart and maybe put it in a more central area. But if I want to put these guys somewhere, I'll go ahead and redraw. Aha! I can complete this castle out here. So I have a lot of defenses down here, and I've got to make my way here. So let's go ahead and just start doing some straight routes over there. We'll start a castle over here, and I could put a militia group out on this road if I get one. But you see, like, this is just a very fun game. This is one of those games that, like, obviously if you want me to play more, I'm gonna do it. And this is the demo right now that is out available for free on Steam. But this is one of those games I'd like download and like play when I'm on a trip, or if my audience was awesome. Like, Baron, well, I can tell how much you're enjoying this. Let's make this a series. So we got Rune of Flames, +1 damage to castles or warriors. I'm thinking this is a good spot. And we've got to continue the road here, but I got to make sure to rotate it properly. And I could complete a nice little quick castle, actually. So we'll do that, have a little castle out here, and we'll continue our roads. And then I'll complete that one, so it's +10 gold. And it seems like it's passive. I build this 10, and they add 1 to my income every now and then. So this is actually a farm. Where do we want the farm to be? We'll put it right there so he's nice and safe. Now, it's probably not advisable to build outwards in the middle of this giant attack, but where do I want to build my next castle and put the heart in it? Because that's the thing. I need to first start with it. If I put it there, or can I put it? Oh, I can put it. No, I can't because of that road. There's a little open road. All right, we'll make this a Rune of the Rock out here because he's got to hold this point all by himself. Yeah, see, they're just bum rushing it, and I'm bum rushing to get to this vault. We'll put a little militia banner right here, and see, this is where I can repair a castle while it's being sieged, actually. So I'd say it looks kind of rough, but we're holding our own, and I can repair the castle seemingly at any time, and depending on its level of, you know, damage it's sustained by the orcs. But I believe probably the bigger the castle, the more damage they're able to do. So let's go ahead and redraw so I can continue. Now, I want to get the heart of the jungle or whatever. Put a farm right over there. And I can build a castle here. I wonder, Am I just going to build the biggest castle over there? I think I am. All right, where are they attacking from? Down there? Great. We'll redraw. We'll put in the heart. And then once I can afford it, I just need 2 gold. I can put this thing in here. And I believe that completes the castle. Oh, no. I actually have to surround it. So I'm going to build like the biggest castle ever up there. But it's going to take a little bit of time, it seems. All right, guys. Hurry up and give me gold. This is interesting. Okay, so after attacking this, they're moving onwards. But this is a pretty well fortified area, I'd say, overall. I'm feeling pretty good about it. If I put the farm there, yeah, I unlocked the card. Okay, so I did my secondary objective. Unlocked all 3 of the vaults, and that gets you new cards. Now, honestly, I want this piece just because I got to complete this super fortress up here. So I'm going to wait for the 2 gold, and I'm going to put a wall section here. Actually, I could just wait for all this gold. So I'm going to do a little bit of that. And I just need 1 more gold to complete a super fortress. Huzzah! Look at that. Okay, so I'll call this the Northwest. The Northwest is probably the best protected. The South is guarded by this little guy. And is there a slow... Okay, there is a slow rebuilding over time. All right, I'm just going to complete this farm to get that 2 gold. And I think I want another castle over here. Where do we put it? I've overextended myself to get down to that card. So a militia will help, and I'll put them right there, closer to the castle. And I'll just restore all the things that I can. And I'll Rune of Rock this fortress as well. Rune of Gust. Why not? Yeah, so as they go, they're going to destroy all that stuff over there. Let's try to complete... Here we go. We can complete this road. Get some passive 8 gold over there. And I'm going to create another fortress over here. Voila! All right, the south is a little bit... Now, we built it in the middle of an attack, so unfortunately, we have to deal with that. What other roads would I be able to complete? Look at that. That castle we just built immediately destroyed. Oh my god. Okay, now they're going to be coming from this side. But we held off, and let's see. We're at, what, wave 5. Beautiful. Oh, there's 4 waves coming from all directions. And the direction that's probably the weakest would be northeast. So if I put a castle here, and where are some roads that I can complete? You can see the roads that are completed because they go from these little dirt roads to these, like, kind of brick paths, which I do appreciate. Makes it much easier to see, hey, that thing's done. So we'll redraw here. And here we go. These farms should be able to complete. I'm going to put that one in because it's in the heart. That means it's going to be easier to be protected. Completing more, just stacking up gold. I should be able to complete a little quick fortress. And we'll go ahead and press play because I need 2 gold to protect the northeastern corner. And look at that. So let's see. I've got 1 big castle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'd say it's been like, I don't know, man, maybe like 6 years, I think, since I played Carcassonne, and I very much enjoyed it. So I'm a little rougher on the edges, I think, in that department. Militia, protect the east. Oh god, they're coming out of the north. Wow. Let's glue this one. And those are some of the things that I'm not as familiar with just yet. But look at this, man. We unlocked all 3 vaults, and I don't know if this is the last wave of the demo. I'd say we did well. I mean, they're still attacking, mind you. But like, look at that. I love the art style. The game mechanics are solid because it takes some proven and established and very fun game mechanics. The tile placement and building mechanics of Carcassonne, the wave defense and tower defense kind of system of like, they are billions, and then the roguelite and card building mechanics of Slay the Spire, all games that I absolutely adore. It's like this game was meant for me. Ooh, speaking of which, let's go ahead and complete that little road section. And I'm not sure where I want to build this next castle. All I know is like, there's a lot of stuff coming in here, and it's really bad right now. So I guess all the gold we're going to have is going to be going to restoring our perimeter fortresses. We'll go ahead and redraw though, just to see if we can't pop something out real quick. I'm thinking I want to build a castle up here somewhere. So if I put it like here, I think I could do this. Beautiful. And that. And at this point, yeah, they're not getting to the center keep, right? So we're doing well. Wave 5 is rough. Aha! So I can view my castle. This is about as far as we got. Unlocked all 3 vaults. It said we survived 17 waves. Was that just all 17 at the same time? Is that because I thought we were at like wave 5 or something? But it's just a beautiful game. Like, this is a solid game. I want to say a big thank you to developers for like going with this like creative direction. So here it is on Steam. It's made by the developer John Bell, Mr. Johnny Bell. You can wishlist the game. Wishlisting on Steam is a huge, huge thing for indie developers. I highly encourage you, if you like the game, download the demo, play it, and wishlist it. Also, let me know if you guys want to see me play more, because it's gorgeous and fun. So thank you guys so much for watching our first episode of Orcs. I'm going to keep an eye on this game, but let me know if you want to see more, and I'll see you in the next video.